with Equipped Creatives, where I help people like you thrive. And this is part two of sleep and worthiness. All right, so this is about what I learned in my Sleeping Beauty Challenge that I gave myself in the month of June regarding sleep and nutrition. So the part one, that was all about sleep and creating a sleeping environment, and this is about the nutrition side. So definitely check out part one, but check this out too. And let me just say something really quick here. So if you are facing this experience like me of just these thoughts that come that you're not worthy, you're not enough in any given situation, that can also affect your sleep because you just feel like, okay, I need to give, pour myself out, and then I am earning rest, then I'm worthy to rest. But if you're in that cycle, you're probably never going to feel like you're ready to rest because there's always going to be something to do. There's always going to be someone who needs you. You need to take that time. You need to have boundaries over that time to rest because you are worthy. You are in divine timing. You aren't behind. You aren't running behind. It's not about perfection. It's not about checking all the boxes. It's about when it comes to wellness, it is about just doing the best that you can with the next steps that you're taking and not to overthink it. Just take the first next step. So, number one, it matters when you eat your meals before you go to bed. So you want to try to avoid eating large meals or foods that are super acidic between 1 and 3 hours of going to bed. So 1 to 3 hours, try to eat very, very lightly or nothing before you go to bed. Just because that, if you have like quite a bit of food in your belly, that may induce acid reflux, that may induce indigestion. So you just wanna give your body time to digest food. Basically, that's what that is. I also love to use peppermint vitality essential oil in my tea. Peppermint tea is also soothing just to help the digestive process go. Also, lemon vitality essential oil is great in a warm, lukewarm tea, and that just helps to get things flowing as well. So that's a tip. Also, you want to, you know, just make sure that you avoid a lot of sugar throughout the day because, interesting thing, if you eat a lot of sugar during the day, first of all, your energy levels are like this, right? Like this, because you're having crashes in the middle of the day. Also, if you eat a lot of sugar during the day and you're having those afternoon crashes, that also sets you up for when you're sleeping to be pulled out of the deep part of sleep. And you don't want that to happen. So you wake up more exhausted. And funny thing is, when you're more exhausted, you're also more likely to indulge in sweet things to try to perk yourself back up. So it's just kind of the cycle that you want to break. But sugar, it's not just soda and it's not just desserts. So it is also in ketchup. It is in juices. It is in sauces. It is in all these different packaged products. A lot of processed food has sugar in it because it's an addictive substance, and the producers know that you will be more addicted to it. So, and want to have more of it. So that's just something that you know they do. So you want to just make sure that you are really looking at the ingredients list on the products that you're getting, making sure there's not sugar in it. The COSE, like anything with COSE at the end of it, that's usually a sugar. So just double check that. And you can just, you know, what I do sometimes, I just like Google something on my phone when I'm shopping. You know, if I really want to check into it. But I mean, in general, just eat whole foods and you'll be fine. So that's my tip with that. Also, number three, avoid caffeine 6 hours prior to going to bed. And I know there's so many people who are not caffeine sensitive like me, and they can go well into the night drinking, you know, strong caffeinated drinks. But, you know, also that tends to be acidic, so that kind of goes along with number one, avoiding, you know, acidic foods before you go to bed. But also, you know, in general, to maintain and really get into deep REM sleep, you want to avoid caffeine. So, and even caffeine is also found in chocolate, guys. I didn't realize that until I had hot cocoa. the other day and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm exhausted because I couldn't go to sleep because it caffeine, apparently it's in cocoa. So something to think about. So those are my tips, and that's kind of what I've discovered is helpful for me to understand, helpful for me to know before I go to bed. And it's made for definitely a better sleep and just feeling better in my body too. So I definitely look into what steps you would like to take, what areas you would like to look at in your nutrition to see if there's anything that can help support healthy sleep. All right, so thank you so much for watching, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and if you like what you're seeing. And definitely check out the links below for more information on how you can join our community, and any helpful things are down there as well. So have a great day. Bye.